It's 4 days since Dfcu Bank took over Crane Bank management. Dfcu managers have revealed the reason for their move. The bank's managing director, Juma Kisame, said taking over Crane Bank will help them achieve the goal of becoming Uganda's biggest financial institution.
The acquisition gives us the impetus to achieve our strategic objective of building a robust retail operation with multiple delivery channels, whilst consolidating our position as a key player in the SME market segment. It also supports our goal of promoting financial inclusion in Uganda.
Kisame assured Ugandans that the bank has the financial ability to run all Crane Bank branches all over the country under their roof of control and management. The chairman, board of directors, Jimmy Mgira, lauded Bank of Uganda for the smooth and transparent bidding process which Dfcu won out of the 13 applicants.
On the ground, as far as the execution is concerned with this project, we've got a very professional and excellent management team led by Mr. Juma Kisame, and we are confident at the board level that we will execute, you know, the Crane Bank project like we have done this before.
Dfcu will now have full responsibility of running all the branches countrywide, considering the over 500,000 clients that came along from Crane Bank. However, there is fear that some of the employees are bound to lose their jobs, especially those operating in upcountry branches where Dfcu originally had branches too. Bank of Uganda took over management of Crane Bank at the end of 2016 after the bank was found in a financial crisis caused by bad debt. According to the Bank of Uganda Governor Tumsime Mtebile, this was putting Crane Bank clients' money at risk, hence coming in before hell broke loose.
Grossly exceeded its assets. Liabilities grossly exceeded its assets, and therefore it was insolvent, which insolvency has continued to date.
This is not the first time Dfcu takes over a bank in such an economic situation. In 2014, Dfcu took over Global Trust Bank. Other banks that have also fallen prey to Uganda's unpredictable economy include Nile Bank and Greenland Bank, among others. This report was filed by Julius Kafuluma for Urban TV.